So, what are your five basket ingredients this week?
Okay, let's see. What do we have here? We have onions. We have sauerkraut. We have homemade smoked pola sausage. Yeah, another one. Guess that's one for me and one for Bob. I don't know what the cameraman's gonna do.
Funny.
Yeah. Oh boy. Corn on the cob from the farm. Okay. Well, first thing I gotta do is get rid of the juice from this bag. So, let's drain this. This is kind of tart, so we don't want all that. We are going to drain this. Get rid of that juice. I'm not going to rinse it, but I am going to drain it. Because I like some of the tartness. Alrighty. Okay. Dump that in the pot. That one I'll have to drain. Alrighty. Now what we're going to do with this, first off, I want to saute a little bit of onion and garlic and add to that. Yeah, cameraman's happy garlic this week. He didn't get any last week.
Or the week before.
No, I think you did get it the week before. Garlic from the farmer's market as well. Alrighty. I've had to stack up on the garlic for the cameraman here.
Much appreciated.
I'm sure that went rolling somewhere. There we go.
Thank you.
Get my ends cut off there. So don't want those. Alrighty. Okay. Whoa, that one went right in the pan. How about that? Princess must be barking at the bobcat out there. He must be by the fence teasing him. It's cute. I let Kelsey out to play with the bobcat now. And Kelsey chases the cat. Then the cat turns around and chases Kelsey. Real cute. I don't know about the princess yet. I think the bobcat's still a little intimidated about princess. Princess is a little big. Okay. I'm going to save this half with these for our grilled onions for our grill a little bit later today. Okay, nice. So, put these in a pan. grill those up a little bit. A bit of olive oil. And we're going to saute those down a little bit. And then add them to our sauerkraut here. Can I have, I could get it if you step back for a minute. Let me get a little bit of butter here. Just a little bit. And that's all I have in here is just a little bit. So that ought to work out good. Just like a little bit of that creaminess from the butter. Alrighty. Just want to saute these just a little bit, get them a little soft. The butter. Salt. Pepper. Take a minute or two. I can throw in my garlic. I'm going to add this to our sauerkraut with a little bit of chicken stock. I have some spices I'm going to get here, some sugar, and I have some starch that I'm going to put in there. Since it needs some liquid, since I took it out. Alrighty. Okay, that's getting a little translucent now. Should just take another minute. And that'll be ready to pop in the pan. Very nice. Onions are jumping out of the pan. Alrighty, let's get our garlic in there. Just for another minute. That smells good, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, get a can opener here, bottle opener. That looks good. I'm going to shut that off and just let it sit there for a minute. Okay. Drink a strout. Okay, we're going to add some dark beer to this. Alrighty. We're going to actually add the whole bottle to this. And something else I'd like to do, my meat. I like to have the flavor of the meat, so what I'm going to do is cut off an end here or two so I can get that same flavor going on in the sauerkraut, just so it has a little bit of that flavor. Not much, because I want to use this for my sandwiches, but it'll be nice just to have some flavor in there. Okay. That ought to do it. Let's get a little bit of that smoked flavor going on. Okay. Okay, we're going to toss in our onions and garlic. They had a toss. Oh, boy, I'm clumsy this morning. Making a mess. Alrighty, I'm going to add a teaspoon of, a tablespoon of some brown sugar here. I'm using the dark since I'm using the dark beer. You could use either, it don't really matter. which one you use for this recipe anyway.
I'm sexy and I know it.
That's all right. That's just Bob. Bob's texting me. Okay. We've got our tablespoon there. And we're going to put in some caraway seed. Good handful of caraway seed in there. A little mustard seed. And I like a little heat. So I'm going to go with a splash two or three of some cayenne. And a little bit of chicken stock. Probably like a quarter cup there. Okay, and we're going to heat this up. We're going to let this simmer off for a while. So mix all that together. Ah, yeah. Smelling good already. Alrighty, so I'm going to chop up some onions for later. And we're going to do our corn and our sausage out on the grill. So we'll be back a little bit later and give us a like on the Bobcat Cooking Show.
Because she's sexy and you know it.
Kathy!
Hey, Bobby!
Unbelievable. I love cooking outdoors.
Isn't it great?
Yeah, that's that coal starter thing.
Yeah. Yeah, I think we're ready to dump it, huh?
Right, and no lighter fluid.
No, we put newspaper underneath the bottom of it to get it going.
All right. Light it on like one
side, right? Yeah, or three quarters of it, because I got corn today, so we've got to need three full.
Wow, they really get hot.
That they do. That thing is smoking, baby.
We got corn today, huh?
We do, and that's what I'm going to put on the grill first, is the corn.
Oh, okay. Let me get this away. Beautiful day, Kathy.
Oh, gorgeous day, baby. Perfect day for grilling. Perfect day for grilling, my sweet love. Yeah, it's cool right now, but...
That's rubber.
True.
Not a good idea.
Not if you can help it.
There we go.
Alrighty. So, got my corn here. And now you could open parts of these if you wanted to get charred inside as well. But we're just going to kind of.
That's nice looking corn.
Leave them. Oh, you know, I saw the Getz sign up there when I was walking today. He's selling corn $4 a dozen.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so he must be growing
$4 a dozen?
For a dozen. That's cheap because I think I was paying $4.50 a half a dozen.
Wow.
At the market day.
I ever tell you that time when I had to go get eggs and my mom gave me $1.25?
Yeah.
And I went to the store and Mr. LaPlou was his name.
Uh-huh.
And I asked Mr. LaPlou, how much for a dozen eggs? He said, 75 cents. 25 cents if they're cracked. I told him, Mr. LaPlou, crack me a dozen. I kept that money, Kathy.
You kept that money.
I still got it, yeah. Was a mess carrying the eggs home, though.
Yeah, I'm sure it was. Yeah. Needless to say, you ended up with scrambled eggs, huh?
Yeah. When I got them, gave them to my ma,
uh-huh.
Yeah, the yolk was on me, because yeah, she wasn't too happy.
No, I'm sure of that.
Oh, they're nice corn.
Oh, that's not so nice. White.
How long does this go, like, takes about?
25 minutes or so.
Okay. Want the lid on it?
Yeah, we'll put the lid on it. Got to turn them every few minutes, though.
Oh, maybe just leave the lid on.
Maybe. Maybe they'll cook better, I don't know.
Oh. Oh, you smell that greenery.
I'm going to put the lid on because then this, all that smoke will get in there.
That hickory?
Yeah, all that smoke will get in there. And I don't mind it if it's, gets a little charred in there. It's fine. Let's see. So it should be ready at least by 5:10.
Oh, wow.
You know, and I got my cabbage over here.
Whoa. Oh, man. Yeah, that was one of the ingredients I got. But you kind of supered it up a little bit, huh?
Yeah, I put, I'm going to take it off the heat and do my onions here. Oh. I got some onions that I cut up earlier I was talking about. Yeah, with the cabbage, I drained it from that bag, you know.
Uh-huh.
And I put some mustard seed in there, and I put caraway seed in there, and
caraway.
Some chopped onion and garlic.
And that gets rid of that sour taste, doesn't it?
Yeah, it helps a little brown sugar. You know, put a little brown sugar in there to sweeten it up a little bit. And then I put some beer in there.
Oh, there
you go. The stout. The Guinness.
If you don't like it, at least you forget what you're eating.
Right. Oh, yeah, I'll get these onions a little bit chopped up over here. Where did my flame go out? There we go. So I'll get those cooking up. Let those saute in a pan a little bit here.
Ooh, you can smell that. You can smell the greenery.
Corn husk?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's see how it's doing. You guys keep turning these babies.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Just keep turning them a little bit every so often.
Now, does the leaving the green on there, does that kind of hold in the moisture?
Well, hold in the moisture, but also when you leave the corn, the husks on here, and then when you go to take them off, if you cook them in the husk, then it peels off, and it peels off all that silk.
Oh.
You know, so you don't have to be fussing with the silk, you know, when you buy corn and you do it in the pad,
yeah.
In the house.
Yeah,
and you got all that silk you got to be messing with.
Yeah. I always get it caught in between my teeth. I got to go get the string.
I put this bigger one in the middle here.
Yeah.
Bigger one. So a lot
of people just boil their corn.
Well, you know, you could parboil it too and then put it on the grill. Well, I can cover it up. When I do it on in the pot in the house, I add a little bit of sugar to the corn.
Do you use regular water, or you usually use chicken stock for everything? You use chicken stock? Or
not for the corn.
Not
for the corn, no.
Oh boy.
I add a little bit of salt water to it, you know, salt or water, but I also put a little sugar in it because it helps bring out the sweetness as well as the salt does.
Oh.
But it helps with the color. If you put a little sugar in it, you'd be surprised how gold and yellow that corn will turn out.
Wow. See that? Yeah, we got both rows going today, aren't we?
Yeah.
Well,
we
just
do.
A side burner on
just
that.
Just a side burner on this one. Yeah, the big boat just sleeping.
Oh, it's got a big party coming up, though.
Yeah, we sure do.
Yeah,
we'll have to maybe get some of that tape that day.
Oh, yeah, see all our friends out there, yeah.
You know, we'll have so much food, we'll probably have both of these going.
Yeah. Boy, we'll feed you.
Might have all three if you get that other one in time.
Yeah.
And they have the burgers going on here, and put some Italian on there.
Oh, yeah, this is where I'm going to hang out then. So I'm going to be like this, Italian burger, like Wimpy.
Yeah.
Be like Wimpy. Wow, yeah. Not bad. Really does.
That was good.
It's half bad.
Isn't it?
Yeah, that device we got is nice. That makes the charcoal so red.
Mm-hmm. Oh, isn't that? Yeah, that's a handy little tool.
How many people you think just throw the coals in there and throw some lighter fluid in there?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah.
Then they heat up too fast, though, don't they, Kathy? Or?
Yeah, they do. And then you have all that liquid lighter fluid that's not really good.
Oh, why, that onion smells so good. Yeah.
Not good to do that lighter fluid. You know, because you get that flavor in your food then.
Mm-hmm.
You ever taste a burger that has lighter fluid taste
to
it?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, can I have some burger with my lighter fluid?
Yeah, right. No mustard, the lighter fluid's just fine.
Well, it's a little safer too, I think, you know?
Oh, yeah. I like this Weber grill.
When paper burns up before you even put any food.
Right.
And the papers are already burnt up, and then the charcoal
it's
is
all
going
natural.
By itself.
You can smell the hickory. You can smell the hickory.
Yeah.
The neighbors are coming now for food. The wind is blowing that way.
Yeah, it is blowing south.
We're all walking out like zombies. Like on the cartoons, Kathy, you know where the smell goes that way and then the people are kind of like floating.
Right,
floating. Like that. We'll give them a sausage.
Let's see how our corn's doing there, baby.
We'll give them a sausage if they want one. Baby. Mm. Oh, look at that.
Oh.
How would you really know like when corn is done? I mean, does it get softer or harder?
Yeah, it's not going to get really that much softer, baby. No.
Corn is corn.
Corn is corn.
So we're more or less, what, just like heating it or cooking it? Or?
Yeah, you're cooking it.
Uh-huh.
You're cooking it.
I hope it ain't popcorn. Well,
no, I guess if you overcook it, it'll start popping.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. I figure good, you know. 30 minutes, good 30 minutes on the grill, 20, 30 minutes is good.
You know what I seen one time too, Kathy? I seen where they put it in aluminum foil. That ain't a good idea.
I've done it myself in aluminum foil.
Mm-hmm.
But there's recipes you can do it with.
Now then you would take the stalk.
You take the husks. The husks. Yeah, you gotta take the husks off if you're gonna put it in aluminum foil.
Mm-hmm.
You know, put it in aluminum foil. You can make a little butter mixture of some sort, you know. Mm. You want some soft butter with some cayenne or garlic.
Oh, boy.
You can rub it on the corn, put it in the foil, uh-huh. Seal it up, stick it on the grill. Well,
that sounds good, too.
I've done it in the oven.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's real good in the oven, too.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, it's real good in
the
oven.
Tight in there, though. It's a small little area to work in, though, isn't it? I don't know how you climb in there, baby.
You're funny, baby. You're funny.
I don't know how you climb in there. Boy, I love the smell of onions cooked with them. Yeah, they might get
nice
and golden.
They smell good, don't they?
Yeah. Ah, man. Yeah, that's why they're all coming out. Man. Mm-hmm. The other neighbor just came out, too. Man.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Well, I put a little bit of salt and pepper upstairs on it, but I want to do a little...
I got a little spice wrap over there.
Yeah, I got a little pepper blend.
Mm. Yeah, we got everything out here in this little kitchen, huh, Kathy?
Yes, we do.
What's that? Pepper blend?
A little pepper blend. Yeah, it's a mixture of white pepper and black pepper. Mm-hmm. Put that in the sauerkraut too. Oh yeah. Yeah, it's looking mighty good. Mmm. That's gonna be good on some Polish, huh?
Oh man. Polish. Yeah, the items I got were pretty good, but I like going to the butcher shop now, Captain.
Yeah. Nice place that we found there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Over there on Roosevelt.
Yeah. Now if we could just find a good fish place, but it doesn't appear that they have one out here.
No, and they got the lake right over here.
Right. Like
20 minutes
They
away.
Have that guy at the market day that sells his
shrimp.
Mm-hmm.
Homegrown shrimp.
Mm-hmm. I haven't tried that.
No, I don't know if I would want
yeah.
to. I don't know. It's kind of different when you buy them in the store, but when
right.
you gotta cut the heads off of them, it's different. I feel bad about that. Lay down, shrimp. You know. Off with your head. Does he give them to you live? Or?
No.
Yeah, I was in a restaurant one time and I asked the... the waiter, I said, how does the chef prepare his chicken?
Uh-huh.
And they said, oh, they just chop the head off. They don't tell them.
They don't tell them.
Yeah,
you know, I saw the chickens on the farm, in the farm next down to us.
Mm-hmm.
I walked this morning, and the chickens were walking around the grounds. They weren't in the fenced area.
Oh, no.
I don't know if he just got out. It was just one of them. The other ones were in the fenced area, but there was one of them, he was just walking around in the grass out in front. I was like, whoa, chicken, don't you belong in that fenced area?
He might be like the He might be like the Daniel Boone of the chicken, where he goes out and investigates.
Yeah, just dropped an onion down there.
Ah, we'll get it.
It'll probably cook up. There won't probably be anything left to it to get. It will probably cook up to nothing.
Will you put just like a little oil in there with the onion? And...
yeah, I did. Just put a little oil in there. And that's it.
Yeah, you got the blizzard down there. He's waiting.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the blizzard. He always likes to sit underneath the table in case we drop anything.
Yeah, but he don't like the people food, though.
All right,
Callie now does.
Callie likes the food.
Let's see how corn is doing. Alrighty, I think we're going to take a break, baby, huh? We're going to turn these again, and we still have about 15 more minutes, so then we'll put our sausage on in about 15. Oh, so we'll take a break and go to Bobcat Cooking Show and give us a thumbs up.
Look at how nice it is.
Yeah, it's coming good.
Yeah, it's got all the sides there, just about all.
Pretty well cooked up there.
Yeah,
we give it another 10 minutes, though.
Yeah, but look how nice.
Mm-hmm.
Boy, them kernels are just golden orange or yellow. I'll get it right away. I'm a colorblind thing here. Good heat.
Good heat.
Yeah.
Oh, you're the princess.
Yeah. A lot of people, too, they don't wait till the coals get white.
Right.
You know, as soon as the flame goes, or sometimes even the flame's still going, they're throwing the burger around there. That ain't
Yeah, I'm going to wait 10 more minutes on this, and then I'll throw on our sausage.
See, there's the sausage. That's the one I got from the butcher shop.
Yeah.
Now, that's already smoked.
Mm, smell that.
Oh, man. Yeah, I'm going to town right now. Yeah, that's smoked already.
Yeah.
Yeah, he had it hanging out of his mouth all lit, and I wrote it later. I said, hey, what are you doing? He said, I'm smoking the sausage. I said, get out of here. Put that. I said, wrap that up and give it to me. But I told him I want a discount.
You want a discount?
Oh, yeah, he had it in his mouth.
Yeah. Well, I took off an end on one of these.
Oh, okay.
Because I wanted to put it in the sauerkraut. Look at this one.
Boy, that smells good.
He's like, where's my end?
Yeah.
All right.
Much appreciated. Dad's ready to put his hand up.
Oh, I know what that noise is that you're hearing. It's Princess. She's knocking on the door.
Yeah.
She wants out.
Yeah.
That's what that noise is that you're hearing.
Oh, wow.
She smells.
Now, when we grill it, then we're going to get that flavor, too, of the hickory.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Oh, that good.
On top of this hickory. So let's see how our corn's doing, and I think we can hopefully put our sausages
on. Boy, it's such a beautiful day.
And then we're going to put our buns on.
People really should enjoy, getting together with the family and barbecuing and having a good time. Yeah.
Not everybody cooks this good.
Move some of these up here a little bit. Gonna leave these on here while our sausage is cooking on.
Oh yeah, you can smell. You're right. You can smell the corn. You can smell the corn. That is really cool. Mm-hmm. Wow.
Whoa.
There we go, baby. Like rolling out the log.
There we go.
Yeah, that's nice. Whoa, Michael. Bowl of sausage, grilled onion, sauerkraut. Don't get no better than this. It don't get no better than this.
No, sorry.
But no, really, it's a nice family thing, Kathy. You get together.
Yeah,
you get the barbecue going. You get the family together.
Family, good food, good friends.
That's what it's all about.
Good God, let's eat.
Yeah. But it is a beautiful day, the birds. But I see the butterfly,
little yellow butterfly. Yeah.
The birds, you must have fed them this. They're all... going over there.
That I did.
Oh, smell that sauerkraut. Whoa, baby, I'm getting goosebumps. Look at that.
Switch these out for a minute.
Oh, that's nice and hot.
Isn't it hot?
Yeah, show people this here. Look at this here. Oh, man.
That got some stout beer in it.
Oh, see that, and it doesn't have that smell of bitter.
The bitter,
It just smells really... Good. Really good.
I don't want to get these too hot.
Come on, I see you can smell the corn, you can smell the sausage burn. Oh, that's
yeah,
good.
Isn't it good? Mm-hmm. That is good.
And we got the blizzard out here. And we're going to toast the buns, right?
We're going to have to put this corn on this tray, I think. We'll put the sausage
on
that one.
I don't think
we'll
the
just
corn.
Throw the corn on this one.
Yeah.
It's in its husk, so it'll be fine.
And then we got to toast the buns, too.
Right, yeah, we're going to toast those buns, baby.
And that adds a flavor to the whole thing. You know, everybody just sometimes looks at just, okay, this is the meat, but you gotta think of the onion or the
sauerkraut, toast
and
the buns.
It's
so good.
It's a whole package.
It is a whole package. All right, so we're gonna take a break while this cooks up, and we'll be back when we put our buns on, I think.
Ready.
Let's
see.
Boy,
I smell the corn.
Doesn't
I smell the
sun.
Oh, let's see. I'm getting weak. I need food. Oh, wow. Look at that. Oh, wow. Oh, the smell, the flavor.
Mm. Oh, looks great, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. You know what? I'm leaving the stalk on.
You're leaving the stalk on?
I'm going to eat right through that stalk.
I think we could take these off and then I could put the bread on.
Let me put this down and help you, Kathy.
I think I got it. Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm just going to put them on that tray there.
Boy, that's that.
No, that tray's my plate, right?
Like you said,
your plate. You hear this guy?
Mm-hmm.
The tray, his plate.
Ooh. I'll take in the sausage.
Yeah, you can have that tray of corn.
Oh,
I'll
never
have
mind.
The sausage too. I guess we'll just let that burn off, huh?
Yeah.
Alrighty.
Oh yeah, here's a tip, right? Because last week when you made them combos, talk about it.
Look at the juices running.
Yeah, look at that. Oh, this is good. This is good. Come on, Bobby Flay, let's throw down here.
Oh yeah, let's throw down, grill champion.
Mm-hmm. Not really.
You know, he likes to grill.
Yeah.
I know Chef Irvine, Robert Irvine's looking to see this potato soup cook-off. He thought that would be a lot of fun.
Mm-hmm. And we do have videos asking him to come out here. And
yes, we do. It's on the Facebook. It's on the Bobcat. It's on his wall, too.
But a lot of the Food Network stars have been emailing you, though.
Yeah, they have.
And Bobby Flay did answer on one of your pictures. Looks good or something like that? Or
yeah.
What? Yeah. Now, this is important. I remember
Robert Irvine is, my biggest one.
Yeah.
My biggest fan.
Mm-hmm. You know, I've been studying to be a ventriloquist.
Yeah.
Now, this is very important.
Oh, yeah.
I remember last week the difference between...
The soft bun
and a little toasted bun is a world of difference, so take the time to do this. But yeah, I'm studying to be a ventriloquist, and you know, it's yours, Kathy. You gotta talk without moving your lips. You know?
Right.
So, watch this now. I'm gonna do a real briefly. Watch this now. You gotta watch, like, pretend this is like you.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Now watch. Hello, how are you doing?
Dinner ready?
Yeah, dinner ready. Oh, there we go.
Oh, there was a dinner bell.
Dinner bell, there we go. Dinner bell. Oh, that's a good idea. Whenever I hear that sound, I'll come running, baby.
Alrighty.
We're almost there, Michael. Almost there.
Almost.
Awesome, because the camera's getting a shake, so it's hungry.
Michael said he didn't eat today.
He's been patiently waiting.
Ah.
He has been patiently waiting.
I can't say the same, Kathy. You know them,
look at
you know them stuffed peppers you made last night? For
dinner? Yeah. Were those
and you
good?
Gave me that one to bring to work?
Yeah.
Oh, Kathy.
Those were good, weren't they?
So delicious. You know, them are good the second day, the third day, the fourth day.
You keep talking about all this food that you're taking to work. Tomorrow you're going to find me in a passenger seat waiting to go to work with you.
Yeah, I heard you were going to take my bag instead of taking your sausages. I heard about that. I have to put like a bell on my bag. And if I hear something at night, I can hear ding, 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 ding at night. Hey, that's mine. You want me to put the top on a little bit?
maybe for a minute.
Okay.
You can do that for a minute. Get these charred up.
You know, talking about a minute, did I ever tell you, I got a friend of mine lost his job. I got him a job at a clock factory, Kathy, making faces all day. So we're going to go 1 minute, right?
Yeah. You going to count?
Starting, well, it's up to what, 66, right?
Yeah. Yeah, we could put this one on the table.
Yeah.
Ooh, the tray's nice and hot.
Ooh, yeah.
Oh, man, I just got a whiff of that corn coming by.
Oh, yeah. Are you going to heat up the onions a little bit?
Yeah, I'm going to heat up the onions, and then we can bring that to the table.
Ooh, does that corn smell good? Well, where do you get the cob, though? Where the corn on the cob? The corn is on the outside of the cob. The cob is the thing that after you eat it, that's what's left is the cob, right?
Yeah. The milky part.
That's the cob.
Yeah. Let's see how our bread's doing. We don't want to burn our bread.
Whoa. I think it's just about there.
Baby. Yeah.
Huh?
Mm-mm.
Slap some butter on the bread while it's cooking.
Oh, man. You even make bread smell good. You know that? I don't know how you do it.
Well, what we could do is start taking these off.
Follow that tray, Michael.
You gotta tell me twice.
These onions up here, they're warmed up a good amount there. Warm this up.
I'm waiting to get into that sauerkraut. Oh, you know what I'm gonna put on my sandwich?
Yeah.
I'm gonna put on the...
Look at him, look at him. Got it? Now you gotta be careful so it don't roll off.
Yeah.
Watch your thumb.
Okay. That's okay if it rolls off. I'll take it.
We'll let it rest there,
Michael.
Can I
leave the top off? Want me to leave
the
top?
Yeah, you can leave the top off.
Get back over here.
What?
Where are you going?
Oh, the table's over there. Oh, okay. Oh, I'm getting senile, baby. Oh, that smells so good.
Doesn't that smell good?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can have
a
sauerkraut.
I like this mint. I might take it to work tomorrow and show everybody this thing. Oh, sauerkraut and onion.
Onions? Wow, just waiting on this bread, baby. Oh, there's one.
Look at how nice that is. Perfect. Perfect grilled onions. There's the sauerkraut.
Oh, man. Steaming hot there, Mike.
Oh, that smells so good.
That smells great. Mm. All the little things you put in there make a difference, Kat.
Yes.
Hey, Ma.
Huh.
Is it ready yet?
Well, I could put yours off ready. Oh, I better get a plate, though, huh? For the ones that are done. Let's see.
Oh, baby.
Let's see here. Some of them I think I could start taking off. That one could come off, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Come off.
Kathy,
Michael!
I didn't ask. This corn from the farmer's market, totally different from the store market.
Oh,
you know?
Isn't it?
Oh, yeah.
Isn't it ever?
And you know what? I got a compliment, Kathy.
You did?
Yeah. The farmer that grew this corn told me I have nice ears.
Well, we finally got proof that we're a corny family.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, look at this. Look at this. Whoa, just perfect.
Doesn't it look nice?
It's so nice.
Got
and
some
warm.
Butter there.
Wow, how nice it just comes off the.
Doesn't there?
Look at that.
Isn't that pretty?
That is.
Isn't that pretty?
Oh, some melted butter.
Oh yeah, let's see. That's got to give this baby a little taster.
Oh yeah.
Mmm. Oh my God.
I gotta, you know what? I like the corn, but I gotta try this. Mm. I got the sauerkraut.
Yeah,
I wanna let people know. I got the sauerkraut on one side. I got the grilled onions on the other side.
Dude.
I'm gonna taste this baby. Oh, look at the size of this thing. Look at this.
Isn't it
look
delicious?
At this.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my God. So juicy.
God.
So juicy.
Wow, is that good?
That sauerkraut is just outstanding.
Isn't it good? Nice flavor, isn't it?
The only thing is we can't call this sauerkraut when Kathy makes it. Because it's not sour at all. It's got a little sweetness to it, like a little a real nice flavor that's not
real mild.
Tart. Real mild, right. Real mild. So good. So good. But I love going down this summer aisle, Michael. I mean, you know, I go past grills and everything, and I see all this food and the farmer's market and everything. Kathy, you go to the farmer's market, too.
Oh, yeah. I love the farmer's market.
Mm-hmm.
Love the farmer's market.
It's unbelievable. But you know what? Try this. Get the grill out. Mm. Get the family together.
Yep.
Try something like this. It's a beautiful meal, huh, Kathy? Mm.
A wonderful meal. And good to have family together.
That's the whole thing, right?
You know, cook with your family. Eat with your family. Back at the table again.
Back at the table again since 2013.
13.
In the meantime.
Yep, bringing families back to the table again.
Five more ingredients next week.
That's right.
Kathy?
Give us a thumbs up. Give us a like on the Bobcat Cooking Show. And we'll see you next week.